Assalamu alaikum students, this is Faiza Ali. If you are new on my channel, please hit the subscribe button. We are discussing chapter number 1, Basics of Information Technology. Till now, we have completed all these topics in my previous lectures. Today, we will study output devices, in which we will cover screens, printers and plotters. Output devices. Those devices that display the processed information into translated form that we can understand are known as output devices. As computer understand the binary language and process all the data into binary form, therefore output devices translate that processed information into our language that we can understand. So output devices helping us out to understand the required information into our language. Generally there are three types of output devices that we will discuss in detail. The first one is screens, and the picture of the screen is also shown as. The next is printers, and the picture of the printer is also displayed as. In the last we have our plotters, and the picture of the plotter is also displayed. Now we have the classification of output devices. The output is classified as soft copy and hard copy. The soft copy is displayed on screens and we get the hard copy from the printers and plotters. Now we will discuss both terms of soft copy and hard copy in detail. Soft copy. Soft copy referred to data that is shown on a display screen or is in audio, video or voice form. This type of output is not tangible and cannot be touched. So we can say that soft copy is present in the computer system that we cannot touch, but we can process that information as per our requirement. And the next is hard copy. Hard copy referred to printed output that we can touch and we can use as per the need. The example of the hard copies are printouts, whether text or graphics, from printers and plotters, etc. We get the hard copy from the printers and plotters that we have processed in the computer system, which is in the form of soft copy in the computer system. Dear students, let's discuss all types of output devices one by one. The first one is screens. Different style of screens like CRT and flat panel are shown as. This is the monitor of CRT and this one is the flat panel monitor. Now I am replacing these monitors with the simple screen to discuss different features of display screen. The first one is size. Screen has different sizes, from small screen built into palm top and laptop to extra large monitors as per the need. The size of the screen is measured diagonally. Now you can observe the arrow shows the diagonal positions to measure. So whenever we say that our screen size is 14 inches, it means it has been measured diagonally. The next one is color. RGB colors are the basic primary colors that are used to create 256 to several thousand variations by blending different shades. Therefore, we can say that all colors are derived from the basic red, green and blue colors. And the next is monochrome. Monochrome is used and it shows the information about the colors of the screen and the monitor, which means that we can get to know that how much high quality of graphics are installed into our computer system. So through colors we can get to know the quality of the graphics into our computer system. The next feature is resolution. Resolution means everything on the screen are made up of dot patterns. The number of dots or pixels per inch determines resolution or the sharpness of the image. A higher number of pixels means a sharper image, which means as the pixels are tightly joined to one another, it shows high quality of images and we can see a clear picture on the screen. The next is video display adapter. Video display adapters mean graphic cards. It is a circuit board that determines the resolution, number of colors and the speed with which image appear on the display screen. Therefore, as quickly image appear on the screen, it shows high quality of graphics. There are three types of graphic cards which has the different specifications that I will show you one by one. The first is VGA. VGA stands for Video Graphic Array and it supports 16 to 256 colors. It depends on the screen resolution. And at 320 into 200 pixels, it supports 16 colors. And at 640 into 480 pixels, it supports 256 colors. And it is called 4-bit color. And the next is SVGA. SVGA means Super Video Graphic Array and it supports 256 colors at higher resolution. There are two graphic modes in SVGA. The first one is 800 into 600 pixels and the next is 1024 into 768 pixels. It is called 8-bit color. In the last, we have XGA. XGA stands for Extended Graphic Array and it supports up to 16.7 million colors at higher resolution of 1024 into 768 pixels. It is called 24-bit color. Now you can note that it has high quality of graphics that support our computer system and shows a better and more clear pictures to us. Now students, we will discuss types of screens. There are two types of screens. The first one is cathode ray tube and the next is flat panel displays. Now we will discuss all these screens one by one. Cathode ray tube. Cathode ray tube look like as. Cathode ray tube is a vacuum tube used as a display screen in a computer or video display terminal. Please note in the diagram that this portion is belong to the vacuum tube and this portion belongs to the display terminal. A stream of bits defining the image is sent from the computer to the CRT's electric gun, where the bits are converted to electrons. Please note in the diagram that this is the portion where electrons are generated. The inside of the front of the CRT screen is coated with phosphor. Please note in that diagram that fluorescent screen is coated with phosphor. When a beam of electrons from the electron gun hits the phosphor, it lights up selected pixels to generate an image on the screen. So we can see the images and videos on the screen easily. This is the basic function of CRT to generate images or videos for us. The next type is flat panel. Flat panel is the latest technology. The flat panel displays are much thinner, weightless, and consume less power to CRT. Thus, they are better for portable computers like laptops. Flat panel displays are made up of two plates of glass with a substance in between them, which is activated in different ways. There are three types of technologies are used in flat panel display screens to produce image or documentaries. The first is LCD. LCD means liquid crystal display. It consists of a substance called liquid crystal, the molecules of which line up in a way that lighting behind the screen is blocked or allowed through to create an image. Please see in the diagram the structure of the LCD where color filters and cathode layers and substrates are attached to one another to produce an image on the screen that we can see. The next type of flat panel display is electroluminescent. It contains a substance that glows when it is charged by an electric current. As you can see in the diagram, when the power is given to the computer system, the cell produces electroluminescence image through the filter and CCD camera, and then we can see an EL image on the screen. The next type of the flat panel display is gas plasma. Gas plasma is like a neon bulb in which display uses a gas that emits light in the presence of an electric current. In the diagram, you can note that electrofluorescent material is filled with the neon gas that helps to produce an image on the screen. After a detailed discussion on screen and its types, now we will study printers. That is the second type of output devices, printers. Printers are used to print characters, symbols, and graphics on the paper, and we can use that paper as per our need. Further, printer has types. There are two types of printers. The first one is impact printers, and the second one is non-impact printers. Let's distinguish between impact and non-impact printers. The first is impact printer. Impact printer forms characters or images by striking a mechanism such as a print hammer or wheel against an ink ribbon, leaving an image on the paper. So, in the impact printers, we use a striking mechanism. In second type, that is non-impact printer. Non-impact printer forms characters or images without making direct physical contact between printing mechanism and paper. Hence, we can say that there is no striking mechanism and we are using the laser lights to take a print from the printers. Impact printers and non-impact printers have further types. Let's discuss the types of impact printers. There are three types of impact printers. The first one is dot matrix. In dot matrix printer, a print head of small pins which strike an ink ribbon against paper forming character or images. Print heads are available with 9, 18 or 24 pins. With the 24 pin head offer the best quality prints. This is the specification of the dot matrix printer. And this is the picture of the dot matrix printer from where we can take prints. The second is daisy wheel printer. Daisy wheel printer uses a mechanism in the shape of a series of petals arranged on a petal wheel having a character at the end of each petal. A character comes into print position by wheel rotation and an image is formed by the hammer strike on the desired character. It is slower than dot matrix printer but better in quality. As you can see in the diagram, this is a petal from where the characters are arranged around the wheel. The last type of impact printer is line printer. Line printer prints a whole line of characters at once rather than a single character at a time. Some of these can print up to 3000 lines per minute. So, line printer provides print within a few seconds rather than to wait for a while. Line printer has two types. The first one is chain printer, as you can see in the diagram, and the second one is band printer. The difference between the chain and band printer is just the infrastructure. Rest of the working is same. Now students, we will discuss the types of non-impact printers. There are three types of non-impact printers. The first one is laser printer. Laser printer use the principle of dot matrix printer of creating images with dots. These images are created on a drum treated with magnetically charged ink like toner and then transferred from drum to paper. These laser printer can produce high quality images of both text and graphics. So, in the laser printer, we use the phenomena of dot matrix printer, but in the dot matrix printer, we use small pins. But in the laser printer, we use a laser light to take a print. So, its speed varies from 4 to 32 text only pages per minute for microcomputers and up to 200 pages per minute for mainframe. The next non-impact printer type is inkjet printer. Inkjet printer sprays small electrically charged droplets of ink from nozzles through holes in a matrix at high speed onto paper. It is cheaper compared to laser printer but lower in resolution from 300 to 720 dpi. DPI means dot per inch and is lower also from 1 to 6 text only pages per minute. It is slower because it creates colored prints as compared to the last printer. It has another type of printer that is bubble jet printer, which uses miniature heating element to force specially formulated inks through print heads with 128 tiny nozzles. And through these tiny nozzles, they create a better quality of the colored pictures. The next type is thermal printer. Thermal printer used colored waxes and heat to produce images by burning dots onto special paper. The special paper is a colored wax paper. The colored wax sheets are not required for black and white output. It produces a high quality printout but is quite expensive compared to other non-impact printers because a very expensive wax is used to take a colored print from the thermal printer. This is also the infrastructure of the thermal printer where you can see that a paper is coated where you can take a different color inks to take a print. After a comprehensive discussion on printers and its types, dear students, now we will study the last output device, that is plotters. Plotters are used to produce high quality graphics in many colors and used for specialized applications, that is architectural drawings, maps, graphs and charts. So through the plotters we can take high quality graphics prints that we can use as per our requirement. Further, there are two types of plotters. The first one is flatbed plotters. This plotter has a paper laying flat on a table like surface as you can see in the diagram. The bed size varies according to the need. 1 to 4 color pens move across the paper and the images are printed by the computer. So this is the working of the flatbed plotter. The next is drum plotters. In this plotter, the paper is mounted over a drum, enabling a continuous output. A typical usage is to track an earthquake readings. So through the drum plotters, we can record the readings of the earthquake. Dear students, let's discuss sound output. Speakers are the most commonly used to have this type of output. Let's discuss speakers. As we use microphone to input audio data to the computer, conversely, we use speaker to get audio output from the computer. So microphone enter data into the computer system and speaker provide the audio output to hear. It works on the same principles to convert sound data into machine usable form. A variety of speakers are available in the market to satisfy the requirement of the users and we can use the microphone and speaker as per our need. Dear students, now we will summarize the lecture. Today we have studied output devices. Output devices display processed information that we can understand, for example, screens, printers and plotters. And screens, printers and plotters are basically the types of output devices. So we can say that there are three types of output devices that I have mentioned in the example. Further, we have studied screen and types of screen. In screen, we have discussed the features like screen size, which is measured diagonally. RGB colors are used to generate more colors. And then we have discussed resolution, that is measured through pixels. And then we have studied video graphic cards, which are used to display high quality images. Then we have studied the types of screens, that are CRT and flat panel displays. CRT has the vacuum tube to display the image, while flat panel displays are flat in size and they are very thin as compared to the CRT. They use different type of liquid crystals and neon gases through which they are displaying images on the screen. Then we have studied printers. Printers provide hard copy of the processed information. There are two types of printers, impact and non-impact printers. Striking mechanisms are used in impact printers, while in case of non-impact printers, we use laser light quality. Then we have studied plotters. That are the last output device we have studied in today's lecture. Plotters are like printers, but provide high quality graphics. For example, maps, graphs, architectural drawings and charts. Further, they have two types. One is flatbed plotters, which is like a plane table, where we can take prints, and the second is drum plotters, where a paper is mounted over a drum to take prints. This is the summary of the today's lecture that we have studied in detail. Thank you for watching my video. If you like my video, please hit the like button and smash the subscribe button.